Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to another daily prophetic message to start your day. Precious saints, I believe this is time for us as a church to understand the season that we are in, that we know that the Lord is coming back soon, but He is going to pour out His Spirit upon all flesh. Now, when we turn to Joel 2, verse 28, and it says, "And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my Spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions." Somebody say, praise the Lord. Precious saints, now you may not realize, but there are so many people around the world sending me dreams, specifically with me in those dreams. Now, either those receiving those dreams, or maybe you've even read those dreams or heard of those dreams, maybe you don't quite understand, because see, this ministry is led 100% by the Holy Spirit, and we go by complete faith. See, you will not notice like me ever asking for money or trying to make things happen, but rather we wait upon the Lord. See, you will notice a constant flow of these dreams, of these visions being received by others, and also I receiving in my own personal time of prayer, but I keep them and I say, God, confirm this, confirm this, confirm this, and so forth. So I want you to hear today's dream that a brother had from Africa. Now, this person has never sent me a dream before. In actual fact, I don't think I've had communication with this brother before, because it's the first time they've reached out. But one thing I understand is God is preparing and bringing together a remnant of the saints within this hour. And the amount of people from within the nations that the Lord is calling me to go to can be common. And I also believe it's, as I said, it's confirmation. But God is about to ignite revival within these parts of the world. So if you've joined one of these WhatsApp groups, let me tell you, these groups on WhatsApp, they are not for fellowship. They are not for socializing. They're not for looking for a spouse. They're not for anything other than intercession. God is starting to bring together a body of intercessors that will start to intercede for your nations. Now, in the coming fastings, you will see that I will do some teachings about praying for your city and so forth. But the key to this revival is intercession, not just relying on Pastor Robert to intercede, but rather a body coming together of the remnant saints, believing and praying for revival to come to your nation, to come to your city, so that God can make a way for that revival to come, that repentance revival that will bring the fear of the Lord back into the church. See, we are not connected to denominations or rely even on invites from churches or ministry to come to nations. Rather, just like the Apostle Paul, he had a vision about the Macedonian man inviting him to their nation. See, this revival will start outside the four walls of the existing church, so that it can revive all that come and taste and see that the Lord is good. Somebody say hallelujah. So it's amazing that God Himself is gathering together people all over the world through the simple instructions and leadings and guidance of the Holy Spirit, so that we must be obedient to that call. We must be obedient to what God has called us to do. So prophecy, vision, and dreams, this is the end time language and communication for this end time revival, because God is speaking through prophecy, dreams, and visions as part of His end time plan, precious saints. See, this will not only draw many back to the Father, but also gather the remnant that may not even meet in person before, but God will lead them together. God will prepare them ultimately for His soon coming return. So once again, this is done so that God will receive all the glory. See, I'm not relying on telling you about dreams or visions I've had for you to just follow me or believe me, but rather God is speaking to people all over the world in dreams and visions to validate the message. And what is the message? The message is the Messiah is coming soon. The Lord is coming to rapture his church at the appointed time. But before that happens, he is coming to pour out his spirit to bring this repentance revival so that he will come for a bride that is without spot, without wrinkle, without stain. Because currently, when he looks at the church, he is saying the church is not ready. The remnant church is not ready for his coming. So imagine God is speaking to us in this hour, and he is calling us to prepare. So these visions, these dreams, you might think, well, okay, pastor is just trying to big note himself. You got to understand, I am not interested in any of those things. I'm not interested in selling you a book. I'm not interested in asking for your money. I'm not interested even in my name being planted anyone, but rather God will always use a man. God used Peter after the day of Pentecost to preach the word, and then 3,000 souls came into the kingdom. God will always use a man. So God will use a man. So it's not about the man as per se, but it is about God upon the man. So God is using man within this hour because he has to use a vessel. So God is preparing. God has prepared me in the wilderness for such a long time. That's why you don't see me trying to collab with other people or trying to connect or try to whatever, but rather I wait upon the Lord for him to lead, to guide, to bring that divine network. Now, God is coming. He is going to come to Africa first in a powerful way. He's going to come to the Asian nations. He's going to come to South America. He's going to come to all the places that are hungry and thirsty. Yes, he will eventually come to America. He will eventually come to Australia, and he will come to the other nations, Caribbean, Europe, and so forth. But right now, he is focusing on Africa because I believe that God had spoken to me when I sold it for everything to go there. And I saw the continent of Africa, and I saw these flames and fire that was all over this continent, and it was starting to go more, because I believe that the African people, they are our intercession people. They intercede. Those that you can also get the prosperity gospel and all the false gospels there also, but God is coming to clean up a remnant bride in Africa, and it's going to spark from there, and it's going to go to the other nations. Those that understand, those that have spiritual ears to hear, let me tell you, this is God, and God is affirming this message. He is coming soon. The rapture is going to happen at the appointed time, but before that happens, he is coming to pour out his spirit in this repentance revival, because there is a new fear of the Lord that will come back to the church. There is a conviction of sin that will come back to the church in a greater measure, in a greater way, but rather that he will prepare that bride of Christ to come. Somebody say hallelujah. So imagine, no servant of God or denomination will be able to receive any glory from this revival. No one will be able to sell it or merchandise it or try to sell their books or anything about them. It will be completely for free, as according to the prophet Isaiah that he spoke about in chapter 55, verses 1 to 3. It says, come, buy and eat, though you have no money. Come, buy, drink and eat. God will sustain. God will provide. That's why you never see us asking for money, because God himself visits people and tells them if they have to do anything, or if God wants us to go somewhere, he affirms it through the people of that nation and also wherever God is moving in this hour. Precious saints, God is moving. God is about to come in a greater way. Maybe you're part of one of these WhatsApp groups. Maybe you're part of this ministry, or used to follow us, used to like us just for the words of knowledges or the deliverance prayers or the healing prayers or whatever. But let me tell you, you will notice that every single message I will say, it is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. That is the message. That is the mandate. God God is saying in this hour, prepare for me a bride, prepare for me that is without spot, without wrinkle, without stain, that he is going to snatch away at the appointed time. It doesn't mean that other servants of God are not preaching, but I have noticed a falling away where some disregard the Lord coming back soon. Some have gone away and start to ask for money. Some gone away and gone into prosperity. Some have gone away and God is saying, no, I'm going to say with those that have remained faithful to me throughout the course. This is not about us having to be in certain situations, but rather us trusting God that he is going to do what he says. I want you to listen to this dream that a brother in Christ had so that you understand. There are many dreams and visions people have all the time. But one that shocked me earlier this week was that this lady, a sister in Christ from Africa, she was from Kenya. She sent me this message and she said, the Lord showed her in a dream that the rapture had happened. The sky was all strange and lightning and different things. And everyone was looking up as though the rapture had happened. And when she started to look up and she heard the sounds, she heard a voice say to her, she says, I sent my servant Robert Clancy to warn you and to prepare you for my coming. As though it was like it was too late because the people hadn't prepared. And then it triggered off the tribulation period. Precious saints, you will be without excuse on that day because God will not only send me, but God is also raising up other faithful servants. They may not be the people that you follow on YouTube. You may think, oh, it's just because they're popular. It has nothing to do with popularity, but rather, have they remained faithful to the message? Have they remained faithful to God in that secret place? Because you know the mark of God upon a man is God upon the man. It's not him himself, but rather God upon the man. God is looking for servants that will remain faithful and will not be what? They will not be steered to here, to there, to there. They will not compromise for any sake, but rather that they will come in a powerful way. So as you hear this dream, you'll then start to understand even more the call that is upon this ministry, and you will start to see it start to expand. You'll start to see it come to pass very, very fast. I mean, there's going to be a quickening, and all those mandates that are blocking us from going into the nations because of the snake bite, they are going to come down for a period of time. There will be an open heaven. I believe God has chosen Africa because Africa itself said no to the snake bite mandates and different things in many ways, where other countries just bowed down to the compromise. They said no. Now they are going to come after those African nations. They're going to try to bribe them with a pharmaceutical and all the different things to try to get them to bow with money and so forth. But I believe this is Africa's opportunity for revival to come and to be an example to the world so that we can see revival in this hour and we can prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So as you hear this dream, then I will unpack it. Somebody say hallelujah.
Good morning, men of God. I had a dream. You were on top of an eagle. But what was shocking me, whilst you were on top of the eagle, you were holding many flags in your hand, and also you were holding a horn. As you were blowing the horn, many people were following the eagle, whilst the eagle was flying. So I was shouting, saying, help me, man of God, help me, pastor. You just said, the moment you are hearing the sound of my sound coming from this horn, automatically you are being blessed. I was crying, but where you were in the sky, but I just saw your hand reaching me down whilst I was on the earth. So, men of God, is like these were mixed nationalities, because South Africans were there, me as a Zimbabwean was there, and many different people were there. But what was really shocking me, when you were blowing the horn, it's like people were hearing the horn. It was like a sound, but in that sound, what I was hearing clear was the end is near, the end is near, the end is near, he's coming again. These were the words which were coming from the sound of the horn that we were blowing. and the sky was blue in color. It was like a large crusade. I can't even explain what I was seeing. I don't have much ways to explain what I saw. Up to now, I don't have the meaning, but many people were following you and many flags were in your hands. But the flags that I saw, many of them were the flags of Asian countries and the flags of Africa. So I don't know the meaning of the dream. I don't know the meaning of the dream.
Praise the Lord, precious saints. So let us unpack this dream. Let us now start to discern and give an interpretation of what this dream meant. So when we first look at the eagle, see, an eagle is symbolic. It represents the prophetic ministry. It represents leadership, authority. When we see an eagle that is flying high, it also means the higher calling. God has called me in this hour to a higher calling in the prophetic, to prepare nations not only with this revival, but most importantly, prepare for the Lord's soon coming return of our Lord Jesus Christ. That is why I say catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. See, God uses the symbol of an eagle to encourage us also to soar higher within this time, despite of what's going on around us. See, eagles, they have an innate sense of when a storm is approaching to fly higher, to higher spots, and they wait for the winds to come and they use the winds to actually glide up higher. So when the storm hits, the eagle sets its wings so that the wind will pick it up and lift it above the storm. So while the storm rages below, the eagle is still soaring above. That means that this prophetic ministry, despite of everything that is going on in this hour, this will still soar higher above, because it is God's purpose to bring about this message within this hour. Now, when I was blowing the trumpet specifically, you will see not only was the sound of a trumpet, the sound of a shofar heard, but also there was a message. There was a translation that was speaking to them also, that was saying, prepare, for the end is nigh, the end is near. It is now time to prepare. Jesus is about to come back soon. Precious saints, you got to understand, with the shofar sounding, we will, you know, it is very common to hear the shofar sounded throughout Israel, especially around the time of Rosh Hashanah, which is the Jewish New Year. You'll see it. They will begin at sundown on a certain date, and we see that this horn is blasted. It's an instrument that releases symbolically God's voice. So although the blowing of the shofar, we see it especially within the Old Testament, it has a further meaning for us today. It's basically the warning is awake from your slumbers, from your sleep, and from your lethargy. Search your deeds and return in repentance. That's the shofar meaning, symbolic in this message. And we see it according to Romans 13:11. And do this, knowing that the time, that now it is high time to awake out of your sleep. For now our salvation is nearer than when we first believed. Precious saints, we've got to understand that we are at the cuff of this. Our world has experienced a major storm as we're seeing everything taking place. We're going to see economies starting to crash. We're going to see they're setting the stage for the Antichrist. We're going to see a one world economy, a world government. All these things are going to come to pass in the time to come. But there is a window that God is giving to us. God is affirming this message. Not only is there a higher calling upon this ministry just for nations, and then you'll see me holding these flags, holding the flags for different nations, in particular for all the African nations, for Asian nations, and other nations that the brother mentioned to me that were there also. It represents nations, but it's going to start specifically in Africa, and it's going to spread. Somebody say hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus is coming soon. Jesus is coming soon, but it is time for revival. If you are a follower of this ministry, if you come across our posts, if you have listened to it, and or you've joined the WhatsApp groups, whatever it may be, God is calling us in this hour to take this seriously, to take the position of someone that is going to stand in the gap. God has called us to be watchmen and watchwomen, watch persons that will stand on the walls and intercede on behalf of our nation, to cry out that revival shall come, that he will prepare. Now, you will see also in this vision, there's so many different people that are following as I'm on top of this eagle in the sky, in the blue skies, right? Even despite, we know that an eagle can rise up above, and we could see that there are many people following, all different nationalities, meaning this is not just for one nationality, but all people groups, all tribes, all nations will come and prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. You will start to see this revival. You'll start to see the outpouring of the Holy Spirit will come in a measure. You're going to hear this. You're going to hear this, but as God is preparing you now. God is preparing you now for when all these things start to happen and start to build up momentum, you'll say, hey, he has been saying this for ages. He's been saying this, and God is coming to affirm it. God is coming to confirm it. God is going to come and do a powerful thing. But what is God calling you? God is calling you also. And even as the brother, he cried out and he said, Pastor, help me. And my reply was to him, as you hear the sound of the shofar, as you hear the sound, the prophetic sound within this hour to prepare for the coming of our Lord, meaning it requires us to seek the Lord, to fast, to pray, to consecrate our lives, to crucify the flesh so that we can draw closer to God as he is preparing a bride for the soon coming return. You also shall be blessed. You know, a lot of people, when they talk about revival, especially in the prosperity movement, they always talk about wealth transfer, wealth transfer, but they never talk about the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We don't have to preach wealth transfer because we don't even have to ask for money. God will supply. God will provide for this revival. God provides for himself. Trust me, we don't even have to do anything. Just as the Israelites were in the wilderness, God provided. God will provide. God is providing. God is going to make a way where there seems no way. He is the I Am. He is Yahweh. He is God. He will provide. That is his name. And he has sent his son that says, I am, I am. And he is with us. He is with us until the very end, precious saints. He is with us to the very end. So I just encourage you today to get excited, to know that God is moving. This is a clarion call for you to understand the importance. You might say, well, Pastor, he talks all this and talks all that. Or, I don't like Pastor's message. I want to go to someone else. If that's where you want to go, then that's where you'll go. But let me tell you, it is the voice of the Holy Spirit we need to hear in this hour. And when you're distracted by so many other voices that are taking you away, if people are directing you to not, that the Lord is not coming back soon, that you are not to prepare for the soon coming rapture, that you are to focus on money or anything else, let me tell you, that is a warning for you today to prepare and come back onto this narrow path, because God is preparing a church. God is coming to bring and pour out his spirit of repentance, revival in this hour, but it's up to you what you choose to do. So Heavenly Father, I pray for each person today. Lord, you've promised to be with us until the end. Lord, I pray for repentance, revival to come to the nations. Oh God, I pray for Africa. Oh God, I pray for Asia. Oh God, I pray for the Caribbean and every Pacific island. Oh God, I pray for America's North and South America. I pray for Canada. I pray for Europe. I pray for every nation on the earth. Oh Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. I pray for Australia. I pray for all nations, Lord, that you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh within this hour. You will do a mighty work in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, I pray that you would stir each person up to understand the importance of staying right before the Lord. Lord, remove every hidden sin. Remove every secret sin from our life, that you may use us, because God wants to use some people. God wants to use those that stand and represent your nation when God's time comes to pour out his spirit. Oh God, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, raise up those servants that have a heart for you and nothing else and will not distract and deter people from anything else in this hour. Oh God, I pray in the name of Jesus, come and bless your people. Come and touch them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. In Jesus' name, we pray and believe. Amen and amen. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Repentance Revival in Australia. It is time to catch the fire of Repentance Revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Precious saints, I just encourage you, if you haven't already, join one of our WhatsApp groups, not for fellowship, not for socializing, but rather to stand in the gap for intercession, to stand upon the wall for your nation and say, God, I know you're coming back soon. Oh God, with the window that you've given us, oh God, I pray that you would pour out revival as we're preparing and as the remnant bride is coming together from all nations, as you are preparing to come and snatch away your bride. Oh God, I pray that you would touch each person from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. Be with them. And if you'd like this today, you can join one of our WhatsApp groups. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram. Just follow us. Follow us consistently in our fastings. Every corporate Friday fast, we're going to keep doing. There's a revival series to stir you up into revival within this hour, precious saints. So from my family to yours, God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you, precious saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.